Thanks for joining us today. I'm Brian Stelter. I know I wasn't the only person who was stunned when this story came out on Thursday. Robert Levinson went missing in Iran nearly 7 years ago. The American government has always said that he went there on a private business trip, but that was not true. He was a contractor for the CIA. A rogue group within the agency had sent him there on an unauthorized mission. Reporters started to find this out years ago. The Associated Press, The Washington Post, The New York Times, ABC News. But the government urged them not to reveal what they knew. And for years, everyone agreed. But this week, The Associated Press and The Washington Post decided to go with the bombshell story.
Stunning disclosures about an American who disappeared 7 years ago.
Robert Levinson, a retired FBI agent.
A secret and unauthorized CIA mission inside Iran.
A secret unauthorized mission for the CIA.
Matt Apuzzo was one of the Associated Press reporters who broke the story, and he's here with me now. Matt, did I get that right in the intro?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean,
take me back to 2010 when you first learned about his true identity and what led up to this week.
Sure. I mean, figuring out that Bob was working with the CIA was kind of just the first step. Mm-hmm. I mean, that in and of itself is a story, but frankly, the calculus on whether to hold that story versus the story we ultimately ran is very different. The reason this story was important and the accountability issue behind the story we ultimately ran was
right, the bungled mission,
that a U.S. citizen was put in harm's way, by elements of its government, mm-hmm. and that is an important story that can't stay in the shadows forever.
Mm. You wrote on Twitter yesterday, I think you said, keeping this secret and deciding when not to keep the secret is the hardest thing I've ever done. You mean in your whole career?
Yeah, I mean, I think it speaks to the intensity of the conversations, both with the government and the family and internally at the AP, and the real weight we gave to this decision, mm-hmm. because obviously it had extreme accountability and government transparency issues, and it had obviously a very serious, we wanted to take the issues of risk and safety into factor as well.
One of the points I've seen you and your colleagues make is that there hasn't been any proof of life for Bob Levinson in about 3 years, is that right?
Yeah.
So some people in the government believe he is not alive anymore.
Yeah, I mean, look, I certainly want Bob to come home. I know that Adam Goldman wants Bob to come home.
He was your colleague who wrote the story, now the Washington Post.
This is a complex issue, right? Smart, ethical human beings can debate the merits of running the story versus not running the story. Mm-hmm. I hope we get to the point soon where the discussion shifts a little bit from why did the AP run the story to, hey, how do we make sure that the CIA can never do this again? And how do we, and why did the government, why weren't they being straight with us for so many years?
You're right that sometimes the ethics issues can be a distraction from the point of the story.
Right, and it's important. I mean, we should be having the ethics conversations, and this platform is the right one for those. But I hope other people start to raise questions of the U.S. government and say, mm-hmm. Does this still happen? Could this still happen? Could this happen today? I still haven't seen anybody answer the question, could this happen to another American citizen today? And if it did, what would they do differently?
Mm. Let's bring in Kathleen Carroll, the most senior editor at the Associated Press. She joins us by phone this morning from New Jersey. Kathleen, I'm hoping you can tell us about what the decision process was up until the story being published. Why did you decide to publish now?
Well, as Matt said, it was a long and very complex set of discussions over a period of time, always with Bob Levinson at the top of our minds. Mm. The story was complete some time ago.
It read that way. It read that it had been waiting around for a little while, yeah?
Well, I think waiting around... Listen, one of the things that we kept coming across was, however impatient we were to publish, our frustration was nothing compared to that of the Levinson family and Mr. Levinson himself. And we try not to make ourselves the center of this issue. Bob Levinson is the center of this issue, and the government and the government officials who sent him off on this mission.
And let's play a clip from Jay Carney, the White House press secretary, who addressed the story in his briefing before the weekend started. And then I'd love for you to respond.
I'm not going to fact check every allegation made in the story you reference, a story we believe it was highly irresponsible to publish and which we strongly urged the outlet not to publish out of concerns for Mr. Levinson's safety.
I'm guessing, Kathleen, that you disagree that it was highly irresponsible.
Obviously, I wouldn't do anything that was highly irresponsible. None of us would.
Mm-hmm.
We've had conversations with people in the United States government about this issue over 3 years, over several different administrations at the CIA, and when they were able to be persuasive that something was about to happen or that something was in motion that might lead to a resolution of Mr. Levinson's circumstances, we took that very seriously and we listened to it. But ultimately, for the reasons that Matt has expressed, and I have too, that, you know, the arguments that the government was making were no longer persuasive. Mm-hmm.
Some people might wonder, by the way, if there's any connection between the Justice Department, another branch of the government, coming after the Associated Press months ago, getting subpoenas for phone records, and now this story, which is rather antagonistic, perhaps, of the government. Is there any connection?
None whatsoever. I can assure you that the topic never came up once during the course of, you know, many hours of discussion.
This does remind us that organizations like yours and this one exist in part to challenge the government, to report what they do not want reported.
Well, not just the United States government, although it's certainly the one that we have had some of the most high-profile disagreements with, but accountability requires us to do this with people who are in governments around the United States and across the world.
Mm-hmm. Matt, I wonder if, having seen the government's reactions to the story, if you feel they are mostly bothered by the publication because it is an embarrassing story about a rogue agent, a rogue unit within the agency.
You know, I certainly don't speak for the government. I certainly hope that, as I said before, I'd like to see the government talk a little less about the AP and a little more about Bob Levinson and a little more about what it can do to make sure this can't happen again. I mean, Bob Levinson was in Iran serving his government, and Bob Levinson was not well served by his government. Mm. And I think that's something we can't lose sight of.
Very well said. Well, thank you for joining us. And Kathleen, thank you for joining us by phone.